We hear about the need for high quality and rigorous mathematics. We hear about the need for all students to be provided access and equity. Do we ever hear about the need for both at the same time? There's compelling evidence that some groups of students are not mathematically proficient and do not have access to high-level and cognitively demanding mathematics problems. There are many teachers and mathematics educators who are committed to providing access to high-level and cognitively demanding mathematics problems to all students. They give presentations at conferences that focus on equity for all students. Unfortunately, many teachers don't attend their sessions. Why is this the case? Well, some teachers, they don't have a problem. They have a solution. Equity is not important. Providing equity means watering down the curriculum to provide access, or they've heard it all. Other teachers may not attend because they say, oh, the session is about equity, not about mathematics. It's the parents' fault. Those students can't achieve. Equity means lowering the standard for everyone else. So let's look at quality. There's compelling evidence that many mathematics classrooms focus only on skills and procedures, using direct instruction of lower-level mathematics problems at least 90% of the time. There are many teachers and mathematics educators who are committed to providing rigorous and cognitively demanding mathematics to students. They give presentations at conferences that focus on cognitively demanding mathematics problems. Unfortunately, the presentations don't often include how to provide access to all students. So why is this the case? Some presenters will say, oh, what's good for one is good for all. Or we learned it this way, why can't they? This is what they mean when they get to the university. We provide equal access to all. Everyone has the same opportunity. But teachers may not attend because, oh, this math is too hard for their kids. This math is only for honors kids. For students in those classes that are planning to attend college, my kids can't compete. But they don't show us how to provide access. Yet, we want all students to make sense of rigorous, high-level, and cognitively demanding mathematics. We want all students to approach the zone of proximal development, not the zone of minimal effort. We want to attend sessions at conferences where quality and equity are infused. We want to walk into any classroom or workshop and see all teachers and students engaged in cognitively demanding mathematics, regardless of their SES language, ethnicity, national origin, or gender. But how can we make this happen? We need to advocate for both equity and quality by ensuring that all of our efforts with teachers and students incorporate both. We need to provide scaffolding to ensure opportunity and access. We need to enrich and enhance the language, not simplify it. We need to motivate all teachers and students. We need to increase self-efficacy. We need to increase understanding of all teachers and students. How do we go about doing all of this? We can start with the mathematics content we want to deliver. We select a coherent set of activities that include cognitively demanding mathematics problems. We assess the needs of our teachers and students. We then look for the appropriate instructional methods that address the needs of the teachers and students. We instinctively know how to front-load the language, to ask questions, to increase teacher or student discourse and engagement, and to provide an environment where teachers or students question each other. We increase our expertise on how to apply the standards for mathematical practice. We enrich and enhance. We work collaboratively. We continuously assess what teachers and students are learning and adapt when needed. But aren't these methods you talk about just good teaching? Is it good teaching if many students are not achieving? Is it good teaching if many students' needs are not met? Is it good teaching if many students don't have access to cognitively demanding mathematics? It's up to us to provide greater access and opportunity to high-level and cognitively demanding math problems by enhancing and enriching the language, by scaffolding, and by using instruction that supports the learning needs of all teachers and students. What will you do to acquire knowledge so that advocating for quality and equity becomes second nature to you? What are your next steps? Think of one thing you plan to do within the next 2 months to advocate high-quality mathematics and access and equity. We can't have equity at the expense of quality. Where access without quality is meaningless, and quality without access is unjust. We must advocate for both.